You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Monday, August 17th, 2020. This week on the Catholic Sprouts podcast, we will be talking about the 10th, the final of the 10 commandments, which is, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's possessions. Or simply, don't spend your whole life looking to own more and to have more. And don't always be comparing what you have to other people. This is a commandment not only that helps us avoid sin, but as we will learn throughout the week, it is a commandment that helps us be happy. After all, the Ten Commandments were given to us by God to help us understand what true happiness is and to help us avoid the things that will just lead us to misery. Now, this commandment probably sounds similar to another commandment that we have already talked about, which is thou shalt not steal. Remember, stealing, of course, is taking something that doesn't belong to us. But this commandment is different. Thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's possessions, because this is the intentions of our heart that come before stealing or doing something sneaky, but they also come before creating a plan for our life that will make us miserable. If we decide to live our life coveting what other people have, whether it's their big house, their fancy car, their great clothes, their Lego sets, their toys, whatever it is, if we spend our life coveting what they have and wanting it for myself, then we will be chasing down the wrong things. Now, this week, just like last week, we are going to look to some incredible saints that celebrate their feast days this week. And because God is so very good, whenever I do this, I look up the saints and I realize it's as if God knew that we would be talking about this commandment this week. And the saints that just happen to be celebrating their feast days on each day this week are incredible examples of lives lived with the right intentions. We can have the wrong intentions and live our life just to get more material goods, or we can have the right intention and instead forget about that, embrace poverty, and chase after Jesus. So the first saint that we're going to talk about is today's saint. She is celebrating her feast day, and her name is Saint Joan of the Cross. Now, Saint Joan of the Cross lived in France. She lived during the 1600s. And when she was a young girl, she was the opposite of a saint. She loved money, and she was known for being very greedy. Her family operated a gift shop near a shrine, and when her parents died young, she took it over, and she was known by all people that did business with her as being ruthless and greedy. She didn't care about anybody. She only cared about acquiring more money and more things for herself. Well, one day this all changed. One day, a crazy old woman dressed in rags came into the shop that St. Joan of the Cross was operating. The woman seemed crazy. She was talking and rambling on and talking about how she knew God and she was so close to God and God had a message for people. Well, most of the people that were shopping that day thought she was crazy. They either walked away from her or laughed at her. But for some reason, Joan couldn't look away from this woman. She listened to her words, and deep in her heart, she felt a stirring that told her that this woman was speaking the truth and that she had come here with a message for Joan. Joan closed up her shop that night, and she was still pondering this message, this shabby woman that had wandered into her shop. She went to bed that night, still pondering, and when she woke up in the morning, she was a changed person. She realized that there was much more to live for than simply trying to get as much as she could and make as much profit as she could at her little gift shop. That she should instead live for Jesus Christ, and that her true treasure should be in heaven. And so she abandoned her shop, and instead she gave all of her money away and became a religious sister. Eventually, she founded an order, and at the time that she died, she had founded many houses, and she devoted her life to serving the poor, the poorest of the poor, people that she didn't care about and would have overlooked before she met that shabby woman in her shop one day. Now, Sprout, St. Joan of the Cross is an extreme example of giving everything we have for love of Jesus and refusing to covet the possessions of another person. Isn't it interesting how God came to her and changed her life through a shabby woman that most people thought were crazy? Well, God is so crazy in love with you that he will use whatever means possible to get close to you. And so, Sprouts, my challenge for you today is pray that you, like St. Joan of the Cross, can get the message when God sends the message your way, that you can be open to what he has to tell you and show you, and that you can say yes to him, just like St. Joan of the Cross.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
Just one more thing, a quick reminder that if you would like to use the Creed, our audio course for families and parishes this fall, we encourage you to drop by our shop and grab a copy of it. We will be closing enrollment after Labor Day, so don't miss this opportunity.